Hi all, welcome to the next lecture on signals and systems, lecture number 36, and topic is DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform. Till now you have seen we had talked about Fourier series, then we had seen continuous time Fourier transform, and then we had seen Laplace transform. This was for continuous signal x of t. Now we'll move on to discrete signal x of n. The equivalent of CTFT is DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform, and Laplace transform, it is Z transform. One thing we should understand is that CTFT and DTFT, these work on stable signals, and Laplace transform and Z transform are for stable plus unstable. When we had learned about Laplace transform, we had seen in the class how Laplace transform can be used for unstable signals also. Fine. With this understanding, let us now start with DTFT. We'll start with having the difference between CTFT and DTFT. So I have continuous time Fourier transform, and I have discrete time Fourier transform. In CTFT, my input is x of t. In DTFT, my input is x of n. Okay, discrete time. It should is x of n, discrete time. Output spectrum frequency omega is from minus infinity to plus infinity. For DTFT, my output spectrum is very important, from minus pi to pi, or 0 to 2 pi. Very crucial understanding over here, the omega, that is the output spectrum, is from minus infinity to infinity, and from DTFT it is like this. Just small reminder for you, we had seen CTFT, right? The CTFT spectrum was like this, x of omega, for one of the signals it was like this. And this was continuous time, right? So we had said that output spectrum of CTFT is continuous plus it is non-periodic. Right. But for DTFT, the most important thing that you must understand is the DTFT spectrum is like this. If I say one example, fine. You can see this thing repeats, minus pi to pi, 0, this is 3 pi, this is minus 3 pi. Okay. So for DTFT, the output spectrum is continuous, but very important thing, it is periodic. Okay. So you have a periodic plus continuous spectrum. Periodic in what range? Minus pi to pi. Okay. So this is the basic difference between CTFT and DTFT. Now let us check out on what is the formula that we will see for CTFT and DTFT. Yeah. For CTFT, my input is x of t. For DTFT, my input is x of n. The Fourier transform, continuous time Fourier transform, CTFT is minus infinity to infinity x of t e raised to minus j omega t dt. We have seen this in class and we have solved a lot of sums on this also. And the inverse Fourier transform, from which I get x of n, is 1 upon 2 pi, yeah, is minus infinity to infinity. Spectrum is from this range, x of omega e raised to j omega t d omega, right? So this was for x of t and x of n. Now we'll check out what is DTFT formula. Okay, the new formula which we'll learn now. Since it is discrete, so how does it change? We'll say, we'll write e raised to x of e raised to j omega. Okay, you can even write x of omega also is equal to integration is to summation. Summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity. Instead of x of t, I will write x of n. Instead of saying e raised to minus j omega t, I will say e raised to minus j omega n. Yeah, dt dn, no, right? So this is the final formula. And the inverse Fourier transform DTFT is 1 upon 2 pi. Just look carefully over here. Formula is it minus infinity? No, it is from minus pi to pi. Yeah, so minus pi to pi since it is periodic. You can see this over here. Spectrum x of omega is periodic from minus pi to pi. So I will write minus pi to pi x of e raised to j omega e raised to j omega n and d omega, right? So these are the two new formulae which we have learned. This is your DTFT formula. This is your inverse DTFT formula. Okay. So important thing over here, spectrum is from minus pi to pi. Okay, over here it is from minus infinity to infinity. So now we'll solve sums on this. Just to understand in your syllabus, sums will come based on formula. Properties of DTFT are not specifically asked, not given the syllabus also. Properties will be there for Z transform and Laplace transform. But we have done a lot of properties for CTFT. So we'll do one or two properties for DTFT. Okay. So basically formula plus a few property sums will be what is going to be asked for DTFT. If you do a few basic sums, you should be good enough to crack sums which are for DTFT. Okay. So I will write once again DTFT x of e raised to j omega is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity infinity x of n e raised to minus j omega n and inverse DTFT. Please write this in your notebooks or in pieces of paper so that you remember the formula while solving the sums. Pi to pi x of e raised to j omega e raised to j omega n d omega. Fine. So with these two formula we can start off learning DTFT. Let us start off with finding the discrete time Fourier transform of standard signals. We'll find only one signal, standard signal is enough. Okay, first signal is x of n is equal to a raised to n u of n. Fine, mod a is less than 1. We have to find the DTFT. Okay, before we start, why is mod a less than 1? Okay, mod a less than 1 means a is between minus 1 and 1, right? What happens if a is more than 1? If a is more than 1, for example, if a is more than 1, okay, this case over here says that a is not more than 1, but if a is more than 1, for example, let a be equal to 2, so what is going to happen? Your x of n is going to be 2 raised to n, right, u of n. Yeah, so how is 2 raised to n u of n? How is the signal going to look like? How is 2 raised to n u of n? So x of 0 is replace n is equal to 0. 2 raised to n is 2 raised to 0, that is 1. Okay, u of n means it is on a positive side. Okay, x of 1 is 2 raised to 1, that is 2. X of 2 is 2 raised to 2, that is 4. Okay, so you have got the hang of it, right? So the signal is going to be like this: 1, then you have 2, then you have 4. Okay, so how is the graph? Graph is going to be an increasing graph. Okay, so it is a unstable signal. As I've told you earlier, DTFT is only for stable signals. Therefore, A should be less than 1, more than minus 1. Alright. If A is less than 1, for example, if A is equal to 0.5, then x of n is 0.5 raised to n u of n. Okay, so how is the graph going to look like? Okay, just see it, plot it and see. If n is equal to 0, it is going to be 1, then n is equal to 1, it is going to be 0.5. you can just do the maths: 0.25, 3.0625, and so on. Okay, this 1, this 0.5, this 0.25, 0.125, and so on. So it is going to be a decreasing graph, therefore it is stable, right? Okay, so very important, A should be of this range over here. All right, I hope you have understood this. All right, let us get back to our sum, please. Fine, so my graph over here will look like this. Okay, I'll just draw it over here. Since I know that A is less than 1, so I can confidently say that x of 0, okay, x of 0 means A raised to 0, that is 1. This is your x of 0. X of 1 will be x of 1, n is equal to 1, so A raised to 1. So I can say somewhere like this, just a guess, the height is just a guess, it will depend on the value of A. X of 2 will be when n is equal to 2, right? So A raised to 2 is squared, is going to be like this. Same graph as this. Alright. So we are just assuming that the graph will be of this shape. Alright, main thing to understand, it is going to be a decreasing graph. Fine. So Bebo stable. Therefore, DTFT exists. Alright, next please. So you have got your curve. Now let us do the sum, actual sum, please. So x of n is A raised to n u of n. So DTFT is therefore x of E raised to j omega is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity infinity x of n E raised to minus j omega n d omega. X of n is A raised to n u of n. Okay, so what does u of n do for us? U of n makes the signal start from the right hand side. Okay, A raised to n E raised to minus j omega n d omega. It is summation, not integration. Okay, so you will have summation n is equal to 0 to infinity A e raised to minus j omega n. Alright. Okay, so you can just expand this if you want. For n is equal to 0, it is something raised to 0, that is 1. Then when n is equal to 1, it is A e raised to minus j omega plus A e raised to minus j omega squared, and so on. Okay, what does general formula say to us? Summation n is equal to 0 to infinity A raised to n is equal to 1 upon 1 minus A. So what condition? When A is less than 1. Okay, so we can use this over here. So what is the final answer? Therefore x of E raised to j omega is equal to 1 upon 1 minus a. A is for me, a e raised to minus j omega. Alright, so what is the final answer? A raised to n, u of n, the DTFT is 1 upon 1 minus a e raised to minus j omega. Okay. I hope you get this, yeah? So this is DTFT. So a raised to n u of n, this u of n, this is discrete, yeah? Please remember discrete, do not get confused between discrete and continuous. Alright? Okay. And now what is going to be the spectrum for this? Okay, you can just plot this spectrum, we'll just do that. X of omega is equal to 1 upon 1 minus a e raised to minus j omega. Okay, this is when x of n is a raised to n u of n. Yeah. Okay, so what is the magnitude spectrum? The magnitude spectrum is 1 upon mod 1 minus a e raised to minus j omega. Okay. That is 1 upon, okay, I can write, so you can write e raised to minus j omega in this way, e raised to minus j theta is cos theta minus j sin theta, right? We have seen this earlier also. So it is going to be cos minus omega minus j sin minus omega. So I can write this as 1 upon 1 minus a cos omega, cos minus it is cos theta, plus j sin omega. Right, so it is going to be, you can just rearrange the terms in the same, 1 minus a cos omega minus j sin omega. So this now denominator is of a term alpha minus j beta term. Okay, or a plus bi or a minus bi term. Okay, so what is the mod of this entire thing? Mod of this entire thing is 1 upon root of a square plus b squared. I think we have forgotten that a over here, yeah, a and a. Okay, so we just rearrange the terms, you will get 1 upon root of, just open up the square, you will get 1 minus 2a cos omega plus a squared. Alright. So if you can just plot the graph of this, if you can plot the graph of this x of omega, you will get this way. X of omega graph will be like this. Spectrum of x of omega magnitude. Alright, you will get a graph like this. We will not go into the values at the moment, please. Just put different values of omega over here and then you will get this thing. Yeah. So you should get a graph like this. What is to understand over here? That the spectrum of DTFT is continuous plus it is periodic. Okay. These two are important understandings for DTFT sum. Fine. Let us move on to a few sums, basic sums first. Find DTFT of x of n is equal to half raised to n u of n, right? Simple sum. We know the formula a raised to n u of n. Spectrum is 1 upon 1 minus a e raised to minus j omega. So compare this with this. What is the value of a? A is half, okay, And what is to be remembered? A should be less than 1. Okay. So what is the spectrum? Therefore, you can say half raised to n u of n will be 1 minus 1 upon 1 minus a. A is half e raised to minus j omega. Okay, this is the answer. Simple. This is a DTFT answer for this. Now, if someone asks you, what is the DTFT of x squared of n? Okay, so if I say find DTFT of x squared of n, x squared is going to be half raised to n u of n whole square. That is, I will say half raised to 2n u of n. That is 1 by 4, right, raised to n u of n. I did the square term inside. So what do you think is the answer for this? 1 by 4 raised to n u of n. So DTFT is going to be 1 upon 1 minus a is what? A is now 4. 1 by 4 a e raised to minus j omega. Okay, please understand, this is a raised to n. Okay, here a is this, here a is this. All right, simple sums for DTFT. Sum number 2, please. X of n is 1 minus 1 2 2. Find DTFT. Okay, simple way they have asked. X of n is given in terms of samples and they have told you you have to get DTFT. So we know the formula, right? Summation n is equal to minus infinity infinity x of n e raised to minus j omega n. Alright. Now, this x of n exists from where to where? This is your origin, right? So origin said 0, 1, 2, 3. Right? So x of n exists from, I'll write over here, x of n exists from n is equal to 0 to 3 x of n e raised to minus j omega n. Right? I'll just put the values over here. X of, so what do you do? Replace values of n over here. So x of 0 e raised to minus j of 0 plus x of 1. So n values varies from, n varies from 0 to 3 x of 1 e raised to minus j omega 1 plus x of 2 e raised to minus j of 2 plus x of 3 e raised to minus j 3. So x of 0 means value of x of n and n is equal to 0. X of 0 value is 1. So 1, anything raised to 0 is 1, plus x of 1 is minus 1 e raised to minus j omega. X of 2 is this 2. X of 3 is again 2. Therefore, you can say x of e raised to j omega is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus j omega plus 2 e raised to minus j 2 omega plus 2 e raised to minus j 3. Right. You can stop at this. This is the answer of your DTFT. So this is DTFT of x of n. Okay, so whenever x of n is given in terms of samples, this is how you must do it. Right. You can expand this further also. You can expand this further also. I will do that for the next example. Alright. Yeah. Next sum, please. Sum number 3. Y of n, I will say y of n is like this: 2, 3 by 2, 1 and half. Similarly, symmetric signal: 3 by 2, 1, half, 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So this over here is y of n, and you are asked to find DTFT, that is y of e raised to j omega. Okay, just for you under, just to make you remember, y of e raised to j omega is sinus y of omega. Okay, you are just writing it in this way over here. Alright, okay. So the answer, okay, I will leave it on you. The answer is quite simple, e raised to j omega summation, okay, n is equal to minus infinity infinity x of n, is it x of n? No, it is y of n, right? So y of n e raised to minus j omega n. Okay, now where does my signal exist from? It exists from minus 3 to 3. Okay, simple, minus 3 to 3. Y of n e raised to minus j omega n. Right. So let us start with n is equal to minus 3. So n is equal to minus 3, what is y of minus 3? Y of minus 3 is, yeah, y of minus 3 is half, right? Half e raised to minus j omega n is minus 3. I'm not expanding this, you can expand this if you are getting confused over here, alright? Okay, plus minus 3, next is minus 2. What is y of minus 2? Y of minus 2 is 1. E raised to minus j omega. What is the value of n? Value of n is minus 2. Plus n minus 3, minus 2 then minus 1. Minus 1 is y of n is 3 by 2. E raised to minus j omega. N value is minus 1. Plus n of 0. Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, and now n is 0. So what is y of 0? Y of 0 is 2. 2 e raised to minus j 0. That is 1. Okay. Now next is, so we have finished n minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, and now 1. So n at 1. For y of 1 is 3 by 2, right? So 3 by 2. E raised to minus j omega n is 1 plus, we are moving this way, okay, from over here we are moving like this. What is n of 2? N of 2 is 1 e raised to minus j omega. What is the value? N is 1, right? N is 2, sorry. Next case over here, y of n and n is equal to 3, okay, that is again half. So half e raised to minus j omega 3. Alright, so you can stop over here, you can, this is the answer, final answer, please, you can stop over here. Alright, you can stop over here in this way, or else you can take it further. Okay. So I can say, therefore, I will use the same color, therefore y of e raised to j omega is equal to 2 plus, right, so I'll take this 2, 2 e raised to 0 is 1, 2 plus 2 times this, right, 2 times this, okay, this is 3 by 2, I'll take 3 by 2 over here, 3 by 2 common please, 3 by 2 e raised to minus j omega, minus j omega plus e raised to j omega. Okay, e raised to minus j omega plus e raised to j omega. Okay, minus minus plus. Plus I can say this, what is common over here? 1. 1 is common. Right. So 1 e raised to minus j omega 2 plus e raised to minus plus j omega 2 plus, what is common over here? Half. So I will say half e raised to minus j omega 3 plus e raised to j omega 3. Yeah. So can you reduce this further? Yeah, we know this thing, right? E raised to j theta plus e raised to minus j theta upon 2 is cos, right? Cos theta. This 2 I will add extra over here. So I will have to negate this 2 also. This 2 will cut. extra 2 over here, multiply by 2. Extra 2 over here, multiply by 2. So this will get cut. Fine. So what I'm going to use? I'm going to use this formula, please. E raised to j theta plus e raised to minus j theta by 2 is cos theta. Okay, I will use this. So final answer is 2 plus 3 e raised to j theta plus e raised to minus theta is cos theta plus 2 e raised j theta plus minus plus e raised to minus theta is cos theta cos 2 omega plus here you have 1 e raised to you have 1 cos 3 omega. Yeah. This is your final answer, please. You can do the similar thing for the previous sum also. You can reduce this further into cos and sines if it is possible. If not, then you can leave it like this. Here you can reduce it to this sum, to this format, and this is the final answer. So your DTFT answer is this way. So basically DTFT sums come based on properties and formulae, more on the formula and less on the properties, especially for the syllabus. Fine. Now we'll see one or two properties of DTFT. We'll see one or two sums, and then that should be the end of DTFT for us. Yeah. Then we move on to Z transform afterwards.